Business and financial news from across the subcontinent now on BBC World in India Business Report.
Kerala, the South Indian state famous for its natural beauty. 400 kilometers from state capital Thiruvananthapuram is the town of Kottakkal, where a traditional Kathakali performance is in progress. It's a solo act episode from the Hindu epic Ramayana. The dancer, playing Lord Hanuman, describes the great battle. Lord Ram's brother Lakshman is seriously wounded, and Hanuman is sent to look for the miracle herb Sanjeevani. Hanuman has no medical training to identify the herb and carries the whole mountain to the battlefield and saves the day. The Ramayana is believed to be 3,000 years old. Of similar vintage is the comprehensive system of medicine that codified the use of curative herbs like the Sanjeevani. It's called Ayurveda, the science of life. Dr. Indira Balachandran is a scientist who has been studying and documenting medicinal plants for 20 years.
About 600 medicinal plants are mentioned in Ayurvedic texts. And all their details, like, you know, rasa, guna, virya, vibhaga, prabhava, etc., that is the properties according to Ayurvedic people, and also description about these plants in Sanskrit slokas, and description and the therapeutic properties.
One institution has been working to preserve and popularize Ayurveda for more than a century now. It grows its own medicinal plants and produces over 500 different types of drugs that generate a turnover of 85 crore rupees, or just under $19 million a year. It also treats over 800,000 patients in its hospitals across India and earns 5 crore rupees, or just over $1 million a year. It's a private charitable trust called Aryavaidyashala. Aryavaidyashala is headquartered in Kottakkal, a town in the South Indian state of Kerala. It was set up in 1902 by Ayurvedic physician Dr. P.S. Warrior. At that time, people were turning away from Ayurveda. Dr. K.K. Warrior, a relative who has also been practicing Ayurvedic medicine for almost 6 decades, remembers.
ആയുർവേദത്തിൽ വിശ്വാസം ഉള്ള ആൾക്കാർക്ക് ഒരു പഴയ ചികിത്സാ സമ്പ്രദായത്തിൽ 100% ശരിയാണെന്ന് വിശ്വാസമുള്ള ആൾക്കാർക്ക് പോലും നല്ല മരുന്നുകൾ കിട്ടാത്തതുകൊണ്ട് അത് ഒരു ചികിത്സാ പദ്ധതിയായിട്ട് എടുത്ത് ഉപയോഗപ്പെടുത്താൻ സാധ്യമല്ലാത്തൊരു നിലയിലാണ്
എത്തിയത്. ഡോക്ടർ പി എസ് വാരിയർ ഡിസൈഡഡ് ടു കമ്പൈൻ ഏൻഷ്യന്റ് ഫോർമുല വിത്ത് ദ ലേറ്റസ്റ്റ് മെഷീനറി ആൻഡ് സയന്റിഫിക് ടെക്നിക്സ് to produce modern Ayurvedic medicines. What he ended up with was a breakthrough no one had thought of yet, the Ayurvedic pill.
This is for the first time Ayurvedic medicines are available in a bottle condition. First time, ready-made. You walk into the physician's room and he gives you the medicine after examining you. That was not available in the past. That has completely revolutionized the healthcare system itself.
In its first year, Aryavaidyashala made a small beginning with medicine sales over just 1,000 rupees, or $22 in today's terms. But almost all of this was through founder Warrior's own clinical practice. Other Ayurvedic doctors still preferred to make their own medicines. Dr. Warrior felt the need to introduce Ayurvedic doctors to Western allopathic medicine. He published a book on modern anatomy for his contemporaries, another first for Ayurveda. Dr. P.K. Warrior, the founder's nephew and managing trustee of Aryavaidyashala, explains.
When he studied both, he understood that the basically this is more scientific, this is Shastra Ayurveda. But there are something to be developed in it. Especially this anatomically, it is the development is a little bit less. There is, but it is not up to the mark.
While his unconventional methods earned him a growing following among patients, his contemporaries continued to ignore his efforts to modernize Ayurveda. Dr. Warrior needed more doctors at the clinic and decided that he would have to train his own. The Ayurveda Pathshala was set up in 1917 and later became the Ayurveda College at Kottakkal.
അതുപോലെ തന്നെ പുതിയ വൈദ്യത്തോടൊപ്പുള്ള പരിചയം വേണം. ഇത് രണ്ടും കൂടിയിട്ട് ഒരു സിന്തസൈസ് ചെയ്യാൻ ചാൻസ് ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്ന ഒരു വിദ്യാഭ്യാസ സിസ്റ്റം വരുത്തണം എന്നുള്ളതായിരുന്നു അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ വിഷൻ, കറക്റ്റ് വിഷനായിരുന്നു. ഇപ്പം മോഡേൺ സയൻസുകാരും ഒക്കെ തന്നെയാണ് പറയുന്നത്.
ഓവർ ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് 7 years, as word of the efficacy of Dr. P.S. Warrior's medicines began to spread, other Ayurvedic physicians began prescribing these to their patients. By 1924, the sale of medicines had jumped to over 71,000 rupees, or just under $1,600 in today's terms. To popularize the medicines further, Dr. Warrior decided to do away with his consultation fee at the clinic. He also started a charitable hospital for poor patients. By the time Aryavaidyashala celebrated its 25th anniversary in 1927, its medicines had become popular throughout Kerala. Sales were just below 98,000 rupees, or $2,200. For his efforts to revive Ayurveda, Dr. P.S. Warrior was awarded the title of Vaidyaratnam, Jewel of Physicians, in 1933 by the British rulers. As the demand for medicines grew, Aryavaidyashala faced a new problem. It was getting difficult to find high-quality raw materials.
These medicinal plants are procured from our forests and natural habitats with the help of professional herb collectors and suppliers who supply them to the factory. But due to rapid destruction and over-exploitation of our forests, many plants have become rare and endangered, and many are on the verge of extinction. The non-availability of genuine drugs in required quantities forced the pharmacists to substitute or adulterate with the easily available and spurious ones, which tells upon the efficacy of drugs.
Dr. P.S. Warrior knew that it would be impossible to grow all the medicinal plants needed in-house. So he decided to set up a 115-acre herbal garden 30 kilometers from the factory. This garden, which was established in 1934, now supplies Aryavaidyashala with the 400 different varieties of best quality herbs that form the benchmark for all external procurement. Aryavaidyashala founder Dr. P.S. Warrior was aware of the void that his death would create in the institution. He had left a blueprint for the future of the institution in a secret will, which he executed 5 years before his death. Everybody, including family members, would be entitled only to a salary, and a board of trustees would manage the organization.
The trustees are 5 people in the family people, and 2 from the Aryavaidyashala, not from the outside. Cannot say it is a public trust. It's a private trust of a charitable nature. but the prop the I mean profit will used only for charity, because 45% now 45% is used for the charitable hospital and 45% the corpus to improve the Ayurveda Shala and 10% in the college. So everything is used for the public utility.
The day begins early at the Ayurveda Shala factory. Workers like Rajan here in the raw drugs section begin collecting the dried herbs needed for the day's production. On an average day, 200 tons of raw materials are processed into medicines.
കാലത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾ വന്നല്ലേ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ ഐറ്റം എടുക്കണം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ട് ചീട്ട് തരാണ്. അത് ഞങ്ങൾ ഈ പെട്ടിയിൽ നിന്നൊക്കെ എടുത്തിട്ട് ഇത് ഇടിക്കുന്ന ഭാഗമുണ്ട് അവിടെ കൊണ്ടാ കൊടുക്കണം. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു ദിവസം ഒരു 10-15 ഐറ്റം ഇവിടെ എടുത്ത്
പോകും. Nearly 400 people work at this factory to produce more than 500 different types of Ayurvedic medicines. Each preparation requires a variety of raw materials that are first boiled together to produce a liquid concentrate. This process takes between 8 and 10 hours. The medicine being prepared here is one of Ayurveda Shala's most popular ones. It's called Yogaraja Gugulu and is primarily used to relieve pain in rheumatism patients.
സാധാരണ അതിൽ 24 ഇൻഗ്രീഡിയൻസ് ഉണ്ട്. പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഇൻഗ്രീഡിയൻ്റ് ആണ് ഗുൽഗുലു. മറ്റ് പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട മൂന്ന് ഇൻഗ്രീഡിയൻ്റ് ആണ് ത്രിഫല. ത്രിഫല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ കടുക്ക, താണിക്ക, നെല്ലിക്ക. ഈ നാല് മരുന്നും നല്ലപോലെ കഷായം വെച്ച് അതിൽ മറ്റ് 20 മരുന്ന് പൊടിച്ച് ചേർത്ത് കുറുക്കി കുഴമ്പ് രൂപത്തിലാക്കി ഡ്രയറിൽ വെച്ച് ഉണക്കുന്നു. അത് പൊടിച്ചിട്ട് അതാണ് ഗുളിക ടാബ്ലറ്റാക്കി മാറ്റുന്നത്.
Over the years, Ayurveda Shala has also introduced preservatives into its Ayurvedic medicines. This allows transport to sales agents in far-flung areas of the country, who in turn supply them to local Ayurvedic doctors. The increased shelf life also helps to manage inventories better at their own outpatient units and hospitals.
അത് മുഴുവൻ പെർഫോമാക്കി മാറ്റിയതിന് ശേഷം നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് 4 പാക്കിംഗ് സെഷനിലേക്ക് അത് നീക്കുന്നു. അവിടെ നിന്ന് പാക്ക് ചെയ്തതിന് ശേഷം അരുവിശാലയ്ക്ക് 1500 അംഗീകൃത ഡീലർമാരുണ്ട്. അവിടേക്ക് ഞങ്ങൾ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് അയക്കുന്നു. കൂടാതെ അരുവിശാലയ്ക്ക് 18 ബ്രാഞ്ചുകളുമുണ്ട്. കൂടാതെ 4 ഹോസ്പിറ്റലുകളുമുണ്ട്. ഇവിടെ ഏകദേശം 75 വർക്കേഴ്സ് ജോലി ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്.
ടുഡേ there are close to 500 different drugs on offer from Ayurveda Shala. Medicine sales account for close to 85 crore rupees or just under $19 million. In a market where other Ayurvedic drug manufacturers like Himalaya, Dabur, Zandu and Baidyanath have built very strong brands, Ayurveda Shala, the oldest player, has practically no advertising or brand building. Munir Suri heads the healthcare practice at KSA Technopack, a leading Indian consultancy firm headquartered in New Delhi.
The Ayurvedic healthcare system is approximately 3,500 crores. It's a highly fragmented market. There are around 7,000 different players. However, the top 6 players would take care of the 85% of the market. Ayurveda Shala has been there for the last 100 years and it has a legacy behind it. At this point of time, with the proliferation of brands happening in this segment, it's extremely necessary for Ayurveda Shala to also extend itself towards the consumer through branding. Once they start to do branding, they'll find that the profits will actually increase manifold and they'll be able to do much better.
Ayurveda Shala officials, however, insist that as a charity, they are happy with the word of mouth publicity through existing medicine users.
Our motive is not profit making. We, of course, we would like to have money for our development, for our charitable work. But that is not the primary objective. Propagation of Ayurveda, research and such things, development like that. You don't find any organization like us in the country or in Ayurveda.
Business and financial news from across the subcontinent now on BBC World in India Business Report.
On the hospital side of operations, the long queue of patients waiting for consultation at Kottakkal hints at its popularity. The chief physician, Dr. P.K. Warrior, examines each patient using the same diagnostic techniques that his uncle, the founder, used 100 years ago.
Ayurveda, it is literally we used to say that the science of life. But science is ever changing. But Ayurveda Shastra, it is not changing. So it is a Shastra. Shastra means there is no change at all. Why? Because it is connected with the nature. It is formed from the nature.
In Ayurveda, the treatment approach is a holistic one. We don't see the patient in compartments or in systems. And actually, we don't look for a particular germ or an organism as a causative factor for that. We treat the patient as a whole unit, as one unit. And so the approach also is different.
Ayurveda believes that diseases are a result of the imbalance of the various elements that make up the human body, and treatments are directed at restoring the original balance. Here, a patient suffering from migraine headaches is being given the Shiradhara treatment, in which medicated milk is being poured on his forehead to calm the nerves. This 14-day treatment costs an all-inclusive 15,000 rupees, or around $330 for patients who can pay. Although all consultation is free at the Arya Vaidyashala, affluent patients pay for their stay, medicines and administration of treatment. This could range from 5,000 rupees or roughly $110 to 40,000 rupees or $808, depending on the period of in-hospital treatment, which ranges from a week to a month. The paid hospital at Kottakkal attracts patients from both India and abroad. Meenu Prakash is a non-resident Indian who has come here from Gibraltar. A nagging back problem that did not respond to allopathic cures brought her here.
We have been coming for 5 years. Our brother-in-law told us that he has come here for 11 years. It has been a lot of benefits. मोरलेस मैं बैंड हो गई थी, लेकिन अब मैं अच्छी तरह से चल फिर सकती हूँ और विदाउट सपोर्ट के मैं बैठ सकती हूँ।
The 140 bed paid hospital at Kottakkal admits and treats nearly 2,500 patients a year. Last year, the paid hospital operations fetched 4 crore rupees, or just under $1 million in revenue for Arya Vaidyashala. Affluent patients like Meenu Prakash help pay for the treatment of poor patients at the charitable hospital next door. Nearly 3,000 such patients are treated completely free of charge every year. Vishnu Mohan has come here to be treated for his spondylitis.
Ayurvedic andarisham atmosphere ഞാൻ ഡോക്ടേഴ്സ് പറഞ്ഞ വളരെ പോളൈറ്റ് ആയിട്ടും വളരെ അധികം സിൻസിയർ ആയിട്ടും വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്ന ആൾക്കാരാണ്
Today the Arya Vaidyashala has a presence in 15 cities across India through 18 outpatient dispensary centers, but it has only 3 full-fledged paid hospitals, 2 in Kerala and 1 in the national capital New Delhi. This is another area that experts feel the institution needs to focus greater resources on.
See, there is a very clear consumer segment which requires these services. The mushrooming of so many Ayurvedic spas in the metropolitan cities is a very good example. The organized players in this segment do not offer services. They are not offering treatment per se to the patients. They are just offering products. Given these two facts, this is the biggest opportunity for Arya Vaidyashala to actually expand its present portfolio of hospitals to about 16 cities, the top 16 cities in the country, and explore this opportunity further.
The Ayurvedashala is already taking steps in this direction, with new branches to be opened shortly in Kolkata in the east and Mumbai in the west. Plans are also afoot to tap the export market with Ayurvedic medicines. But Vedashala officials accept that they still have some way to go to meet the rigorous clinical trial standards expected in Western markets.
Our trials, our results are not so well documented, which in a way which is acceptable to the modern scientific community. So we have difficulties in exporting our medicines abroad. We are trying to get over them by modern methods. We have adopted modern methods in production.
The Centurion Ayurvedashala of Kottakkal has played a crucial role in keeping the ancient science of Ayurveda alive and healthy in India. Observers feel a more holistic approach to its financial health in the areas of brand building and geographical expansion will certainly help in today's marketplace, and in the long run, help its efforts to popularize Ayurveda across the world. Parivurasi.